I was originally gonna call this video my top 5 favorite games that I've never played, where I talk about 5 games that I've always wanted to play and I'm super interested in, but for one reason or another, I've never been able to. But then I realized the reason I've never played any of these games is exactly the same every single time. I have never owned a PlayStation. So instead, today we're gonna be talking about a bunch of reasons why I should probably just get a PlayStation. And by that, obviously, I mean the most recent PlayStation, the PS4. Now, you may have heard some rumors out there that there's a PS5 and it's out right now, you can go buy it. But unfortunately, based on my research, I have found that it's just that, just rumors. It doesn't actually exist. It's like Bigfoot or something, so sorry. You know what's really cool? Escape rooms. Solving puzzles, using your brain to follow the clues, using absolutely anything and everything at your disposal to make it out. I love that kind of stuff. That's actually the first reason why I should probably get a PlayStation, so that I can play the Resident Evil games. Specifically, Resident Evil 1 Remake, Resident Evil 2 Remake. Mostly because I don't know that much about the other 5 games in the franchise. I might like them, who knows. What? What? There's 22? Now, technically, Resident Evil 1 Remake isn't a PlayStation exclusive. I'm pretty sure it originally came out on the GameCube, but I don't have one of those either. And Resident Evil 2 Remake is definitely a PS4 exclusive. I'm pretty sure. I should probably look that up. But it's not on the Switch, which is the only one I got. I've watched full Let's Plays of both of these games, and I already know I'd love them. I don't really care that much about zombies one way or another, but a big convoluted mansion filled with puzzles created by a crazy person? Yeah, I could shoot some zombies for that. I also don't usually get that excited over graphics in games. As you know, I grew up with a Wii. But even I gotta admit, the graphics in Resident Evil 2 Remake, oh my god! But Resident Evil isn't the only franchise I've been missing out on over in Nintendo Land. In fact, there is an entire pillar of the gaming pantheon that I know basically nothing about. And that is Final Fantasy. Ever since Final Fantasy VII, the mainline games have been nowhere to be seen on Nintendo consoles. Final Fantasy XV came out a while ago, and from what I've seen, the story seems pretty great. A boy band going out, fighting Dark Lords in fedoras, driving around in cars, learning the meaning of brotherly love? Yeah, sign me up. But the one I'm really sad I missed out on is Final Fantasy VII Remake. Now, I've never actually played the original Final Fantasy VII, so I don't have any nostalgic attachment to it or anything. I just think it looks really freaking cool. I can't speak much to the gameplay because, again, never played it, don't have a PlayStation, but the story alone seems worth the price of admission. Video games as a storytelling medium specifically is something that I feel like people don't talk about that much, and I wish they did, because in my eyes, games deserve as much respect as like books or movies or something. Now, admittedly, if the story was all I was interested in, I probably don't need to buy it at this point because I've watched all the cutscenes like a movie, so I've got the gist of it. Even without playing it, the story and specifically all the characters just hit so hard. The writing, the animation, and the voice acting are all top-notch and make everyone feel so real and grounded even as the story gets bonkers. The main four specifically, Cloud, Barrett, Tifa, and Aerith, are all done so well, and I was so invested in them even without actually having my hands on the controller. And I cannot even imagine how much I would love this story if I could actually play it, which again, I can't because I don't own a PlayStation. The next reason why I need a PlayStation? Bugsnax. What is this game? Seriously, what the hell is Bugsnax? I've seen like one trailer for it. I know there's got like Muppets in it or something, and there's like food that are shaped like bugs or bug that's shaped like food. I don't know. And I need it. And the final reason why I need a PlayStation, I started to talk about it before I got derailed by Bugsnax, the stories. Now, don't get me wrong, Nintendo makes some great games, some of the best in the industry, but they generally follow the philosophy of gameplay first. Now that's not a bad thing, not by any means. Mario is one of, if not the best franchise in video gaming history. Every single one of his mainline platformers is widely beloved, and the story every single time boils down to evil turtle kidnaps your girlfriend and you just put off saving her for so long because you're having too much fun jumping around. A game doesn't need to have a good story in order to be a good game, but you know, it'd be nice if it did. When it comes to Nintendo games with truly great stories, there are definitely some out there, but the pool is, let's just say, shallower than it could be. Just to put it in perspective, a game that I've seen come up a lot in the conversation of best video game stories in Nintendo games is Xenoblade Chronicles, a game with more poorly executed villain plot twists than a farce. Don't at me. Why, Zanza? What is that? What's the deal? Why? And over on the PlayStation, you've got The Last of Us, a game with pretty basic third-person shooter gameplay that made the entire gaming world shed a collective tear, or let's be real, many, many, many tears over just how great the story is. Sure, maybe the idea of jaded old man and child go on adventure and learn to love each other is nothing new, but the way it was executed here just made it resonate so much with people. You know, it's the little things, like when you're just walking through a city, there's no real danger, and Ellie is just casually trying to teach herself how to whistle. It's things like that that made people care so much about these characters, and it's things like that that can only be done in an interactive media like video games. And that is something that I have never been able to experience because I don't have a PlayStation. And while we're talking about storytelling in video games, I gotta talk about the most recent God of War. A lot of people drew parallels between this game and The Last of Us with their shared themes of fatherhood, but just saying that this game is Nordic The Last of Us would be doing it a disservice, because that has its own story to tell. And the way this game tells its story through the gameplay itself is so cool, like how Atreus, the son, literally becomes stronger in the game as he matures throughout the story, and just as Kratos comes to rely on his son, you come to rely on Atreus in battles. And let's talk about Kratos for a second. In the beginning of the game, he's trying to bury his rage-fueled, anger-filled past and try and be calmer and a better man. And lo and behold, the way the combat is designed, if you give into that rage and just try and go ham on enemies, you're not gonna make it too far. Instead, you gotta be calm, careful, and deliberate with your attacks, which is exactly what Kratos is trying to do, and that is cool and something that I have never gotten to experience because I don't own a PlayStation. I could probably go on, but I think I'll end off this video right here. But before I do, I have one last message for the folks over at Sony. That's right, that's right. I knew you've been watching this whole time. I wanted to play it cool, but now that it's just us, let me propose a little deal. I just spent an entire video stroking your ego, promoting a product I've never even touched, all completely free of charge. I think we can both agree that it would only be fair if, you know, we had a little give and take. Now, I'm not asking for anything big, no, just like, I don't know, maybe a brand new PS5? Yeah, I know they're real. I know they actually exist. Just a $400 console. Yeah, I'm okay with the digital one. That's fine. Just that in exchange for free, high quality promotion like this? Seems like a no-brainer to me. It's just good business right there. So, if you wanna reach out to me, I'm not hard to get in touch with, and we can hammer this out. Well, I'll be happily awaiting your response, Sony, and in the meantime, I'll end off this video right here. Let me know in the comments below a game that you've always wanted to play, but for whatever reason, haven't been able to. I'm interested to hear what you guys have to say. If you guys liked what you saw, you can hit that subscribe button and the bell or whatever freaking stupid thing YouTube's making you do nowadays to get notified when new videos come out. You can also follow me on Twitter at TheChipTide. There's probably something funny going on over there. And if you are still livid with me about roasting Xenoblade Chronicles, please direct all your fury towards at editor Richard on Twitter. That is at editor Richard. All right, I'll see you guys in the next one.